We got the hottest nails with the flyest host. DJs on the ones and twos giving it the most. There's no need to boast, there's no need to brag. We're just talking Terps, so just grab a slab. Listen up closely, I might be moving too fast. Welcome to the capital of the land of dance. After a long day of monotonous work, I sit back and tune in to Talking Terps.
Yo! What up? We back, baby!
Bob, what up, my brother?
What's good, Dro?
Yo, you saw that early fuck up I had, right? We got it out of the way.
I don't even know what you're talking about.
It's out of the way. And guys, we're in the building for another installment of the show that we lovingly refer to as Talking Terps with Mystic Gammers. Everybody make some motherfucking noise! So yo, shout out to everybody that made it through the last week.
Fuck yeah.
We're alive.
There's some fuck shit going on.
Oh yeah, there's definitely fuckery in the air.
Please.
But we do have new decorations in the studio.
Hey!
We got a new... Oh yeah, besides this, you know what I'm saying? We repping all the time. But
24/7.
We got a big giant fucking boombox in here. I don't know if you guys noticed.
I don't know if you saw
that
shit.
We got a giant... Oh, shout out to all my vendor fam in the building. You know, yo, I got love for my vendor fam. You know what I'm saying? You see the squad. We here.
Yeah,
we got
yeah.
that gang here. You know, we out here.
We out here.
Yo, shout out to Boom for the big fucking boombox. That shit is lit. I appreciate that.
It's like a... Yeah.
And in celebration of this new addition to our museum here, I had to bring out the rig that had the boombox and the little opal. You know what I'm saying? So if you could zoom in a little on that, you see just how fucking fresh your boy District Dabbers is. All right? That is a fucking boombox there. All right? We did that just for you, DJ Boom. You see that? We love you. Now, I'm not going to try to take the credit and say that I debuted it on my show because I didn't. I was a guest on Stoner for the People last Friday. And I actually brought it out for his show. And then I felt like, fuck it, why not do it on my own show? Duh.
Please.
It's a fucking no-brainer.
Please.
So, yeah. Shout out to Boom for inspiring me. And shout out to my fam. Fuck my life. Fuck, who made me this rig?
Ursula.
Ozark, shout out to my motherfucking bro, Ozark Glass, okay? You see, I'm not a dick like that. There's so many glass makers I know that I love and I've dealt with. And
Yeah,
shout out to my fam, Ozark Glass, for coming through shout with my dope-ass rig. And yeah. So, I don't know if you guys know, but the KKK tried to come out to D.C. and do some fuck shit.
Fucking did.
And they were immediately shut down by nothing but real G's. You know what I'm saying?
Thwarted.
And I actually have some footage, if I'm not mistaken.
Can we
shout out
this?
To my bro, Dirty Knuckles, Fuck Trump. Now for a word from our sponsor.
Fuck Trump.
All right, well, we had his understudy hold it down. Okay.
We are all Dirty Knuckles.
But yeah, at the end of the day, shout out to my bro Knuckles for getting this footage for us. And I think Jacob has some footage for us too. Shout out to the engineer Jacob for holding it down.
Yeah.
Let's show how we shut down the fuckery.
Oh shit.
Yeah, fuck him.
Back up! Let's go, back up!
Hey, back it up! You lost in 1865! You lost in 1945!
Back it up! Back it up!
You're gonna lose in 2018! You lost in 18.
Your haircut looks bad!
Back it up!
Fucker!
You look like a child!
I guess you fucking fuck!
It does matter!
You fucking
faggot!
Your sunglasses look dumb!
It feels like the feeling is mutual.
Either way, you're not
Look at how the love overpowers the hate. That's the perfect example of love overpowering hate, ladies and gentlemen. Let's make a huge round of applause for yourselves. All right? That's how love overpower hate. Them dudes had no chance in this city. They had no chance out here. We're too strong for that. And I'm glad that none of my people fell for the trap and got jammed up and is fighting no cases behind no bullshit. Because at the end of the day, those protesters, those KKK people, what they were antagonizers and inciters. And what they wanted to do was they wanted us to act a fool and fucking do the coonery and the buffoonery that they say we do. And they wanted to be able to sit there and laugh at us and basically troll us. All right. And we didn't let that happen because love overpowered hate. And I'm proud of this city for that. You know what I'm saying? So, yeah, shout out to everybody that was a part of that, man. Shout out to my bro Dirty Knuckles for that footage. Shout out to my fam Jacob for the footage. And now for an official word from our motherfucking sponsor. He said that shit with so much feeling, though. That's why I love my G, you know what I'm saying? Like, he ain't just saying that shit because it sounds good rolling off the tip of his tongue. He really mean that shit. So, yeah. I gotta wet my gullet. All right, with a freshly wet gullet, I will echo your sentiment, my friend. Fuck Trump! Yeah. Fuck you, Trump! You filthy animal, you. You fucking walking Cheeto, you. So, Bud, how have you been, my brother?
I'm great, baby.
You're good.
How are you?
I mean, you know. I'm doing good. I'm trying to stay busy. You know? Oh, I should turn this thing back to me, right? Wait, let me get that back. All right. Boom. All right. Hey, guys. I'm
there
back.
We go. So, yeah. Well, they were just watching the TV. So, yeah. You know.
I let them. I didn't want them to miss out on anything.
Oh, of course not.
They're
watching.
For me, it's been getting the kids ready for school.
Shit. That's around the corner, right?
I'm very fucking happy that school is about to start. I've never been more happy that school is about to start. These kids killed me this year, bro.
Is that Virginia? Early? Yeah.
I think next week is go time.
Shit.
We're like there.
That's real shit.
But you know what that means, right?
That means you get the house.
The kids is out my motherfucking house.
Yes, that means move location.
See, the thing is that me and my kids have come to a crossroads this year.
Oh, shit.
I think my youngest daughters have figured out that daddy got a little bit of change. So I remember when, you know, they used to be like, daddy, can we go to the dollar store?
Oh, no.
Like, daddy, I want tater chips. Now they be like, yo, daddy, I want this $175 book bag.
Yo.
It's fucking to carry books, my nigga. Why you need a $175 book bag? Oh, but it's fancy.
Daddy's stunting with the MCM, you know, going
but
in.
But daddy, it's fancy. Oh, and then I got to buy these fucking slippers right there. These like Jesus slippers. What the fuck called? Birkenstocks. Yo, my nigga, I could buy two pairs of Air Force Ones for a pair of these damn Birkenstocks.
Your kids like Birkenstocks.
My nigga, she's walking around like Air Jesus. You know what I'm saying? She loves these shits. I'd be like, daddy want to buy you these Jordans. She'd be like, nah, I want those all white running Nikes. Like, she don't even want no, like, she don't want no Maxes. Like, wow. I mean, I guess I should be happy about that. But then she hits me for like $150 book bag. I'm like, what the fuck? Then I'm in the kitchen minding my business the other day. I don't know. I might have been like putting a schmear on a bagel or something.
A schmear.
You know, I got a Jewish friend here. I just wanted to show him that I knew my Jewish terms. You know what I'm saying? So, yeah, shout out DJ Boom in the building. You know what I'm saying?
All right.
So I was putting a schmear on my bagel minding my own business.
Of course.
And then my kids like gallivanted to the fucking, what's the word? They traipse on in.
Oh, of course.
I'm using big words today. They traipse on in.
We're getting our
and
money.
And they're like, yo, dad, Uncle said he wanted to take us to the mall. And I'm like, that's what's up. Uncle's a great man. God bless Uncle for that. You know, Uncle rocks.
He doesn't know.
Yeah, but we kind of want to go shopping and boom. I said, mamita, yo, daddy didn't say nothing about no mall. It was Theo talking about you guys are going to the mall. Why are you pressing me out for money? This is Theo trying to be super uncle. Why I got to step in here, you know?
You know why.
They gave me this fucking look with these pouty eyes and these lips. And then I was like, you know what? I'll give you $100 each. Get out of my sight.
Wow.
So, yeah. They figured it out, bro.
They're like, You didn't give him a 50. You gave him 100.
I had to.
A piece.
I had to. One of them is 11. I don't know if I should give him 100. And then I had to tell her, yo, you better not spend this on Chipotle. Like, my 11-year-old, she loves.
I'm buying Chipotle for everybody.
She loves Chipotle. So I told her, you better not spend this shit on food. You better come back with something tangible. And she did.
They all went to Cava.
Yeah, you know. But yeah, they've cracked the code is the key that is the point I'm trying to make here.
They ready to hit Uncle's.
So now daddy got daddy can't pockets. Come home with all this fly shit no more. Daddy stopped shopping. Because I got to lead by example. So I'm going to live poor so my kids think we poor again. I'm gonna put like watered down Kool-Aid in the fridge. I'm going to let them see the moldy part of the bread. Like they don't know nothing about that. My nigga, they don't know nothing about no syrup sandwiches.
They have no idea.
My kids don't know nothing about that. I'm going to have to like remind them that ketchup daddy comes sandwiches. From famine. My nigga, they see the circle driveway and shit. They think they Fresh Prince of Bel-Air. So, yo.
You got them out there like that, man.
Bro, it's been a... Yo, shout out to my fam, Whiskey Tiger Gold in the building. Bro, it's been a while, and I think I got to tell them about the events first, right? I have to.
Go for it.
I would like you to tell them about your event first, good sir. We have the 10 Tigers.
Oh, yeah. We got the jump off.
We were celebrating the birth of hip hop the other day.
Oh, yeah, of course. So, bro, you know, August 11th.
I'm passing you the ball here.
It went down in South Bronx, Cedric Avenue.
Yes, sir.
Cool Herc set off that first hip hop jam. And, you know, due to that. Getting it in with a nice little hip-hop throwback party.
If it wasn't for Kool Herc, we wouldn't have any mumble rappers.
We wouldn't have any of this right now. We'd still be listening to disco or something.
I can't believe I just said that.
Some shitty version of disco. So to kind of take you back to that good feeling, and you know, really in the 90s, the Vintage Crew, I think if Jay can hit the button and give us some
footage. We got a nice commercial here.
We can check it out and vibe out, see what we're doing. And...
Hey, all right. Hey, look. Hey, you guys caught me. But they catch me. I knew I had 20 seconds, too. Jacob, I'm sorry I failed you.
It's okay.
In my mind, I had an extra 3 seconds that just...
We are doing...
I was off of the count, bro. I fucked up. So, yeah.
We good.
Every Sunday night, though.
Every Sunday night.
You know, every Sunday, we here with my bro, Phone Homie.
Phone.
For, you know, the Slab Hour, the foundation.
Shouts to Phone
My Homie. Mentor, my motherfucking broski. You know what I'm saying? Phone Homie. My man was off in Alaska for the last week doing a lot of crazy shit. Like, I got to remind him, like, yo, bro, we're kind of old and shit. We got these hips and knees that ain't the same as they used to be. And, like...
That's a state of mind.
When I see my bro on a motherfucking slip and slide, I worry about his safety.
But he did it.
And you know what? He doesn't worry about his own safety. Fear is not in Phone Homie's vocabulary. Yo, bro, that's my brother, yo. He's a wildcat, yo. So shout out my bro Phone Homie, man. He's here every motherfucking Sunday night. You know what I'm saying?
Slab Hour.
And it's on and popping. And then, every Tuesday night.
Every Tuesday.
Every fucking Tuesday night.
Every fucking Tuesday.
We are in the building for the show that we lovingly refer to as Talking
Terps with District Dabbers.
Everybody make some motherfucking noise. Yo, let's take a zoom of the crowd real quick. Let's show the... You think it's a fucking game, people?
I think they think it's a
You think it's
game.
A game? We got a big fucking boombox in here. We are not for the play. All right? We got musical guests and shit. We got fucking Terps. We got, man, it's fucking lit. Can you turn up the volume on that boombox for me, please? I need that 3 notches higher.
All right, we lit.
The funniest shit in the world. DJ Boom comes out the studio today, sees my sis. He says, hey, how are you, nipple waxer?
Oh, wow.
She's famous.
She,
my nipple made her famous.
Nipple waxing. Yeah.
So yeah.
Wow, it's a spirit animal.
And then there is another event to announce.
Oh shit! Tell them what's up.
Catch your boy District Dabbers at the motherfucking World Reggae Festival this Sunday at RFK Stadium.
Oh shit!
Come on down to the Terp Town Village at RFK Stadium and holla at your guala.
Reggae jam?
It's on the poppin', baby.
It's
on the poppin'.
So you already know.
You want to see me? Come see me at RFK, my nigga.
Yeah,
I'm
buddy.
I'm getting poppin', all right? I'm going to have T-shirts on deck. I'm going to have hats on deck. I'm going to have enema terps on deck.
Easy. Star.
Come get your enema dabs this Sunday, all right? This Sunday.
No.
My fam Capital Skunk will be administering all enema dabs at my booth.
Stop.
This Sunday.
No way.
Yo, don't forget to tune in every Monday night to the Manito, man. You got the show popping, you know?
Shutting us down.
Stoner for the People is going to be his registered nurse's aide.
Wow.
You know what I'm saying? So don't forget to tune in to Stoner for the People every Friday night. All right, guys. Yes. I want to remind you that we are shooting a live show.
Yes.
So we're allowed to make noise when prompted, but please shut the fuck up. I'm shooting a live show. All right, here we go.
All right.
Now, the time has arrived.
It's the time?
I think the time has come.
It's here?
It might be here. Time for a word from our sponsor while I heat up this torch. Or heat up this nail. That part. Every bit of that part. You see my fancy fuck Trump like mosaic and shit behind me though? Huh? We fancy out this motherfucker. He didn't make that out of toilet, you know, bathroom tiles and shit. He drew those, okay? That's not used bathroom tile, okay? That is artwork of the fuck Trump variety. I would venture to say this is pop culture. This is the new pop culture art right here. So, get hip. This is my new Warhol hanging behind me. Is that the battle cry of my people? I think we're almost there. Oh! It's about to go down. Yeah. Go DJ. That my DJ. See the fucking hips though, this is the trick to it all, right? You gotta have the motherfucking hips in it, right? And the stage has a new little hop to it. I feel like I'm on a trampoline with it, so my hips is like, woo! Now we glob. Shout out to the Manito Trilly motherfucking Wonka. I'm going on some of this gelato. Me right in the wieners. Oh my God. That shit just massaged my soul. My weenus hurts. That's my weenus, ladies and gentlemen. And it hurts.
Oh, fuck me.
Fuck. Fuck Trump. Yes, yes. Yes. Yes.
Yes.
Yo, I'm sweating underneath my middle pinky toe nail. The middle of it, just the little center part of it. The left side is good. It's just the center that's a little fucked up. And then, yeah, I think I got a little sweat over here on my spinal area. I'm sweating in weird places right now. I got sweat behind my ears.
Oh, I needed that. I fucking needed that.
Cough to get off.
Indeed, good sir.
You know it.
Oh, man.
Shit.
That was wonderful. I know it looked like I died a little bit.
Hey.
But that was wonderful. It made my soul smile. It's great.
Just that step closer.
So now just give me a second while I get my life together here, right,
get
guys?
Get your fucking self together.
I'm I don't know what the fuck. I do this shit for fun too.
Okay.
All right. Feel better now. I feel like I can deliver this news now. But first.
News blunt.
Yes. Now I gotta get into my serious journalistic pose. You know what I'm saying? So, hold on. Let me see what's my best journalistic look. I wanna look like I'm very, you know, very deep in thought while reading this. You know what I'm saying? I'm working on it. Hold up. We're gonna set up. There it is. Can we get like that ticker sound? That. See, this is how you set up a shot, ladies and gentlemen, okay? All right?
I'm teaching
you on the fly.
From Talking Terps.
All right.
It's Jay all day. What's the news?
Okay, here we go. This is, there it is. Thank you. This just coming in from the wire. I am your on the spot reporter, Jay yes. All Day from District Dabbers. The news that's coming in right now is that the weed cultivator gets caught with pot brownies cooling on the stove.
Oh, shit.
In Lee County, North Carolina, a marijuana grower was caught by the cops with 16 pounds of illegally grown cannabis and pot brownies cooling on the stove.
Wow.
This guy's awesome. The house of the grower, Michael Allen Cheeseman, was invaded last Wednesday due to a case called Operation Herbworthy.
Damn.
Fuck you, 12. By the local police, when the police entered the home, they first found the brownies just cooling on the stove. Shortly after they entered the master bedroom and found the plant Cheeseman was growing, right after that, they found several other plants growing in the bathroom closet. And then the police went out the backyard. There, in his back shed, they found 13 more plants growing. The police report stated that the setup was a sophisticated growing facility. Yo, bro, this guy is at the peak of cultivation. I'm just so glad they stopped him before he was able to take over the world.
He was ready to take
over.
I'm
sure like 5 bodies dropped in the time that they did this.
Turkey boogers. What the fuck is that?
That's the fucking results of the Terps. These are available at the pop-up for $5.99, okay, ladies and gentlemen? Wow. Terpy Mocos. These are fortified with the best in Terps, all right? You don't want to put the dee-dee-dee-dee-dee. That's news too, bro. Terpy Mocos. Terpy Mocos for the people, all right? They're all available for a limited time.
Terpy Mocos.
So, boom. Cheeseman is looking at a single count of trafficking marijuana by possession, an extra charge of trafficking marijuana by manufacturing, possession with the intent to sell and distribute marijuana, and maintaining a running place for an illegal controlled substance. So they hit him in the head. And to add to that, Cheeseman received a misdemeanor for possession of drug paraphernalia. That's like insult to injury. Like, oh, you got bongs? We're charging you with that too. You old fuck ass nigga. Fuckery is what it is. He is currently sitting in the Lee County Jail with a $200,000 bond. I wish that someone put a fucking GoFundMe or something up here I could have shared. That beat in the background is so serious, though. All right, I got to tell more news because this beat needs more news on it. Nevada is anticipating that their marijuana tax revenue to get up to about $70 million by the end of this year. When state officials and lawmakers planned on legalizing recreational use of cannabis and retail sales, they had an agenda to generate revenue through state taxes. Right before the vote to legalize it occurred, supporters of the legalization defended the bill by saying how much revenue it would bring in through the taxing and can use for, you know, how much it would bring in through taxing and how much that, the, you know, the Nevada schools could use that. And they were right. $70 million right. Prior to the retail sales on July 1st of last year, lawmakers revamped the tax structure for the state's cannabis industry. These changes were a big player for the sizable amount of revenue that Nevada is anticipating. The state's cannabis taxes vary based on whether a sale goes to a medical or to a retail buyer. First, cultivators will pay a 15% excise tax on wholesale cannabis sales. Next, retail stores pay a 10% excise tax on each sale to a retail customer. But if the sale goes to a medical buyer, the 10% excise tax does not apply to the retailer. And then both medical and retailer buy, this shit is very confusing, I know, but listen. And then both medical and retail buyers have to pay an additional fee for the regular sales tax for their cannabis purchase. The overall total of those taxes is what is causing the expected $70 million in the state's first year and a half of legalization of recreational marijuana use and retail distribution. When it reached the one-year mark, it reached $50.3 million. By 2019, the governor of Nevada, Brian Sandoval, expects the state's revenue will hit $120
million. Wow.
So you might be asking, what might they be doing with all that money?
Swimming in that shit.
Well, part of it will be going back into funding the regulation of Nevada's cannabis industry.
All right.
The price to fund Nevada's legal cannabis program for local government and the state is about $45 million. Fuck. What's left of the money will go to Nevada's public schools. Let's have a round of applause for that. So basically, Nevada's public schools will receive about $25 million from the 15% wholesale excise tax. The revenue from the 10% retail excise tax for non-medical buyers will not go back to schools, but will go into Nevada's savings account.
Because the state needs money. They got to get their cheese.
Everyone's getting their little piece, right?
Yeah, but they're giving the money to the kids.
The kids are getting $25 million.
That's dope.
And you can't be mad at that, right?
Nope.
That for me seems like a win.
Because other states, it's the lottery. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah,
so
I'm happy with this news I just delivered there. I got a little more, though.
Hit him.
New studies reveal that CBD may be beneficial in treating nicotine addiction. Oh, shit. You will pry this from my cold, dead hands, motherfucker. I don't have a problem with my nicotine addiction. A recent study published in Addictions suggests that CBD could be capable of decreasing triggers in nicotine addicts when they were given just a single dose of a dose. When we give them single doses of the cannabinoids. This study shows that everyday cigarette smokers were given either CBD or a placebo. Those participants that were given the cannabinoid were less stimulated by images of cigarettes and tobacco products. So how did this work? According to the study, the molecule could be capable to rewrite memories that were associated to habitual behaviors. If this theory is proven to be valid, this could make the compound crucial in treating all kinds of drug addiction, including dependencies on one of the most addictive drugs known to man. I fucking hate my intern. Nicotine.
I hate you, you little prick.
He's you keep sliding in this fucking vapey shit.
He's just trying to help you.
I love you.
That's it. Thanks, Jake.
He always slips it in. This isn't Jake. This isn't Jake's doing here. Okay, here we go.
There we go.
Memory plays a major role when it comes to behavior. For this example, most addicted cigarette smokers... Okay, hold up a minute here. Most addicted cigarette smokers, a stress reliever, it gives them a stress reliever or a reward. Through this, smoking becomes associated with stress relief in your subconscious memory. What the researchers did in this study was show participants images of cigarettes to see if CBD treatment caused changes in the way nicotine reacted to associations that would usually trigger their cravings. When they did this, in comparison to the placebo, the participants given 800 milligrams of CBD responded less to images of cigarettes. Additional research on the matter suggests that cannabinoids could alter the process of habit formation, acting as an interference between memory formation and habitual behavior. I'm habitually letting my J turn off because I'm reading this fucking rave. This news. I'm trying to get high here too, you know? I'm trying to medicate here. Habitually. In a review that was published in the Neuroscience Journal, it made a claim stating that the endocannabinoid system could potentially disrupt a process called memory reconsolidation. That is when the brain recollects a memory and then alters the memory to ensure its accuracy, which then causes small changes and corrections. Although the actual way cannabis alters memory is still unknown, cannabis more or less has an effect during this reconsolidation process. I sounded it out. You heard me, right? Which unlinks the memory bridge between behavior, environment, and reward. I feel like extra smart after reading that story, bro. Like, should I smoke with my pinky up? Go for it, bro. I will do. Use of CBD products for health becoming widespread. In a survey statistic that was published in the Journal of Cannabis and Cannabinoid Research, the use of CBD products as a way of treatment of either a specific health condition or for a general healthy lifestyle is becoming prevalent among the general public. The scientists at San Diego State University and at the National University of Natural Medicine in Portland, Oregon, they ran an experiment of a self-selected cohort of 2,409 respondents with regard to their use of CBD products. The participants in the study ranged between 55 and 74 years of age. About 62% of the participants claimed using the CBD for the intentionality of treating a specific medical condition. The most common claimed medical conditions were pain, anxiety, and depression. About 36% of the participants claimed that CBD treats their medical conditions very well by itself, whereas only 4.3% claimed the substance to be largely ineffective. For researchers' conclusion, they stated, "The use of CBD among individuals for both specific health conditions and general health and well-being is widespread. CBD is being used as a specific therapy for a number of diverse medical conditions, particularly pain and inflammatory disorders. In addition to anxiety, depression, and sleep disorders, a large percentage of respondents indicate that CBD treats their conditions effectively in the absence of conventional medicine and with non-serious adverse effects. These data provide a compelling rationale for further research to better understand the therapeutic potential of CBD in treating chronic pain, anxiety, depression, sleep disorders, and other medical conditions." Ladies and gentlemen, that is the motherfucking news. You heard my sponsor, right? Remind them. You heard the man. Yo, Cheeto, you got the motherfucking awful, my nigga. I know you love that word. Yo, I made it to the end of the news, guys. I'm very proud of myself here. I was worried. I was worried I wasn't gonna make it.
You did a great job, man.
Where's my fam at, though? Where is you know what?
Hey, Jake, can we go to that? They deep in the couch.
Can we go to that commercial for the World Reggae Festival? I did.
Come on, we know you guys, Jake.
Yes, I did.
Yeah.
I mean, we could probably just go. I think it's actually up on my page. That might be, if that's easier.
Yeah. Boom. Here we go.
Tune in every Tuesday night from 9 to 10 p.m. for Four Homie Presents Talking Terps with District Dabbers, you heard? Then I want to hit this right quick, too. It's your boy Jay from District Dabbers. Holla at your guala. If you're from Australia, holla at your koala, you heard?
There you go. Well, he's high on Terps, bro. You are on Terps.
He's on the neck. He's on the neck. About to come out right here.
Look at your glasses. I get very macho, man. Yeah, Randy Savage.
So we're talking Terps, baby. So all we do is talk Terps every fucking day. Definitely every Tuesday. Don't forget to tune in for the Slab Hour too. Look at my babe. Saying it with sincerity. Saying it with conviction.
You can hear it.
You can hear it. Diamonds in there, bro.
There's a gas muffin in here. Come closer, cameraman. Let's see if you can hear it.
Tuesday night from 9 to 10 p.m. for Four Homie Presents Talking Terps with District Dabbers, you heard? Then I want to hit this right quick, too. It's your boy Jay from District Dabbers. Holla at your guala. If you're from Australia, holla at your koala, you heard?
There you go. Well, he's high on Terps, bro. You are on Terps.
He's on the neck. He's on the neck. About to come out right here.
Look at your glasses. I get very macho, man. Yeah, Randy Savage.
We're talking Terps, baby. So all we do is talk Terps every fucking day. Definitely every Tuesday. Don't forget to tune in for the Slab Hour, too. Look at my babe. Saying it with sincerity. Saying it with conviction.
You can hear it.
You can hear it. Diamonds in there, bro.
There's a gas muffin in here. Come closer, cameraman. Let's see if you can hear it.
Yo, we back. Talking Terps with District Dabbers. I got the fam Note in the building. Note, what up, my dude?
What's good, man?
Man, look, sis, she been hitting me. She been telling me I got to get you in the jump. And so, you know, we're gonna let you rock for the people.
Well, yeah.
I want you to introduce yourself to the people.
I mean, shout outs first to Linda. And shout out to my boy Derek for having me on the show. You know what I'm saying? I go by Note, like the music Note. I dropped the C. A lot of y'all know me by C Note, Ozone Pilots. I'm here today, you know what I'm saying, to let y'all know. I'm dropping my album next month. Shit, man.
It's going to be available on all platforms, correct?
All platforms. Apple Music, Spotify, you know, Tidal, everywhere.
That's what's up. Yep, so do you have any other projects out right now for the people?
Right now, I have previous music Under the Ozone Pilots.
Okay.
My boy Spaz.
Okay.
You can look that up on YouTube.
All right. And then, so now, what's your current IG address and like all your socials and like your SoundCloud, so the folks could, you know, they could log on and get more familiar with you. You know what I'm saying?
Right, right. You can follow me on Instagram at note9220. That's at note9220. And you can follow my label at Ozone_Pilots. And yeah, man.
That's what's up, bro. How long you been doing the music then?
Shit, man, I've been in the game for like 5-6 years.
Okay, okay.
Professionally.
That's what's up.
So I actually been on this show before. Well, I've been on Eddie Kane's show.
Okay, so you've been on the network before.
Yeah, I've been a listener.
So this shit ain't new to you. No, this shit ain't nothing to you.
Nah.
So sis was telling me you ready to go through the walls of Jericho with DJ Bud. Like, you ready for whatever. Like, he could throw beats at, we could do whatever. That's what he told me.
Anything, man, anything. You already know it's going down.
I think like, look, D's over there looking real overly confident and shit. Like, you know, I don't know. I haven't listened to nothing. I'm not gonna lie. I've been busy. I've been out of town. Like, I missed you last week. You weren't able to come through.
Yeah, so, man. I
but you see the stage we got
that.
You was, about to rock on my J.
Oh, yeah,
you got
for sure.
I can't wait.
That shit is beautiful up there. Now, last week, I apologize. I was actually in the studio in Philly with.
I can't
Gilly
be mad at you for working, my dude.
You know what I'm saying? Yeah. Shout out Gilly the Kid. That record's gonna be crazy. Tune in for that. It's gonna be crazy.
So, yo, you ready? You ready to burn it down on the stage and
you
shit?
You already know. I gotta hit that J with you first, boss.
Of course.
Name of the song we gonna drop is called Treetops.
We're doing a like joint called Treetops. We getting high as the treetops in this motherfucker. Shit, it's factual. This shit, oh my god, this is, I got a good feeling about this. Alright, I mean, look, I got a good feeling. Guys, shout out the fam Note in the building.
shout out to Jay for having me.
Yo, bro, thanks for pulling up though. And we're gonna get you lined up over here to do your shot and shit, let's get it. I'm amped up for this. Alright, we in for a treat.
Let's get high like treetops.
So let's run that commercial one more game while I get the stage set up and yeah, we start. Awesome. It's time.
Tune in every Tuesday night from 9 to 10 p.m. for Four Homie Presents Talking Terps with District Dabbers, you heard? Then I want to hit this right quick too. It's your boy Jay from District Dabbers. Holla at your guala. If you from Australia, holla at your koala, you heard?
There you go. Boy, he's high on Terps, bro. You are on Terps.
He's on the next bus to come out.
Look at your glasses. I get very macho, man. Yeah, Randy Savage.
So we're talking Terps, baby. So all we do is talk Terps every fucking day. Definitely every Tuesday. Don't forget to tune in for the Slab Hour, too. Look at my vein. Saying it with sincerity. Saying it with conviction.
You can hear it.
Diamonds in there, bro.
There's a gas muffin in here. Come closer, cameraman. Let's see if you can hear it.
Yo, we back. Talking Terps with District Dabbers. I got my fam Note. He about to go in. We got the new stage set up. Yo, I like the way this shit look, though. Look, this shit. The backdrop is serious,
hella dope,
though.
Hella dope. Check.
You on?
Turn me up a little bit. Okay, there we go. There all
right,
go.
We about to get to it. No, you ready to get to it, my dude?
You already know, Jay.
Boy, you ready to get to it, my dude?
Hey, you downloaded that second record, brother? Yeah, Treetops.
Treetops.
We getting high like
we get high like Treetops, you heard?
Up in the air. Three shots. Drop that.
So, yo, this is what we're going to do, man. You're going to close the show out for us, man. I want to thank everybody for coming out tonight. You know what I'm saying? I want to thank the whole support staff, the whole squad, sis, my bro Nico the Freako, motherfucking Jay, motherfucker JC the Barber, Dirty Knuckles, DJ Bud, motherfucker. Oh my God, look at the. We high as the treetops out this motherfucker. You think we playing?
Real.
Thank you to everybody for coming out, man. It's your boy Jay all day. Holla at your guala. If you from Australia, holla at your koala. You heard? My fam C no shutting it down.
Second record. Second record. Okay. Here we go. Turn it up a little bit. We're going to rock this shit out real quick.
I'm in the O.
With my what? Hold up. Try to see. No. Hi.
Bitch, you getting high like treetops. Up in the air, three shots. High like treetops. Chilling the lair with three thoughts. High like treetops. Stay high like treetops. They like, how did you get way up there? High like treetops.
high like treetops. They like, how did you get way up there? High than treetops, I ride Reeboks. I got my cheese out smoking dope. Fuck my probation, I'ma use detox. I'ma keep smoking all this dope. She keep me shaking, she free daily. I'm a free agent, let's consult. I got my weed from a hippie. I got my seats from a hoe. I got my watch in the prison. Diamonds was cut by a sword. I tell your bitch I can't cancel. What she thought the hell was for? No smoke, fucking I'm a vision. I be just chilling on the 10th floor. Lambo, they give me the Aventador. I know they see me before getting high than the treetops. Up in the air, three shots. High like treetops. Chilling in the lair with three thots. High like treetops. Stay high like treetops. They like, how did you get way up there? High like treetops. Ooh. Up in the air, three shots. High like treetops. Chilling in the lair with three thots. High like treetops. Stay high like treetops. They like, how did you get? Let me talk to you, man.
High like treetops.
High up and I am up and away. Fly up right next to a plane. Can't see the ground or terrain. I swear that these views so insane. Boy, you better not. Boy, you bullets be falling like rain. Boy, you better not complain. Cause you know my pilots, we came with the flame. Up in the treetops. Whoa. When the beat drops, weed sparks, titties fly. Bitch, we get high on the regular. Smoke on that clothesline, I feel like a wrestler. Got no reception, no need for a cellular. Next stop is the nebula. Whoa. Up in the air, three shots. High like treetops. Chilling the lair with three thots. Hey DJ, cut that real quick. We gonna go to the next record. This record right here, some real shit. How many of y'all out here desperate? Desperate for the bag. Desperate to make success. Desperate to get to the top. Anything that you desperate for, you gotta grind for that shit every day. Put it all on the line. Get your ass up and hustle. You feel me? Yo.
Had to go secure the bag. I was desperate. True finesse, never lag. I was desperate. All this drip, hella swag, make them desperate. Big bitch, hella bad, but she desperate. If you really, really want it, go and get it. Had to put the pressure on them in their chest with it. You gon' see I'm not a force to be messed with. Cause the only way you get it is desperate. I was fighting through the mud like it's quicksand. Sinking fast, I had to come up with a quick plan. So much cocoa with the dope up, I need six hands. You go loco every time you see my bitch dance. I got enemies, hate to see me get stacked. Cause it get like 10 degrees, freezing when my wrist flash. Drowning in my memories, can't get stuck up in the past. Feeding off my energy, I'm just trying to make it last. I'm feeling desperate, I gotta get it. I'm not the one to be messed with. Bringing up checks and keeping them separate. Then I'm in the edge. Boy, I got leverage, I need a beverage. Fucking the world till it hemorrhage. I'm taking the money to Paris. I'm taking a hand up in marriage. I'm doing all that I can manage, even through critical damage. That's how you move when you're desperate. You gotta stay cool when you're desperate. There ain't no rules when you're desperate. Gotta do what you do when you're desperate. I ain't go fool with the two in the crew. We pull up on you if we desperate. Had to go secure the bag, I was desperate. Just finesse, never lag, I was desperate. Make them desperate. Big bitch, hella bad, but she desperate. If you really, really want it, go and get it. Had to put the pressure on them in their chest with it. You gon' see I'm not a force to be. Cause the only way you get it if you desperate.
3 months on the bunk, I was stuck in jail. Slimy nigga, grimy nigga, saddle with a sale. 40 racks on the lawyer, 5 on bail. Fuck the case, prosecutors wanna see me fail. Fuck them all, cop the plea, got 2 felonies. 90 days behind the bars, then they set me free. I had nothing when I came, I lost everything. But I can quiet, so my pilots got me in it. Wait, I need it, believe it, so I achieved it. 3 years probation, I can't wait to complete it. They peeping, me dreaming, they creeping, they scheming. I keep it, that Nina, my people, they reaping. These hoes, they geeking, they desperate, they fiending. I freak them, then leave them, that loud pack be reeking. Get this shit by any means, bitch, I'm desperate. We rob your niggas and your team, now what you left with? Had to go secure the bag, I was desperate. Drip finesse, never lag, I was desperate. All these drip pella swag, make them desperate. Think bitch, hella bad, but she desperate. If you really, really want it going, had to put the pressure on a minute. You gon' see I'm not a force to be messed with.
way you get it if you're desperate. Had to go secure the bag, I was desperate. Took finesse, never lag, I was desperate. All this drip, hella swag, make them, thick bitch, hella bad, but she, if you really, really want it, go and get it. Had to put the fucking pressure on me. See, I'm not a force to be messed with, cause the only way you get it if you what? If you desperate. Bags, G. Shout out Jay, man. Shout out everybody
for coming
out.
I see you, my G.
Thank you, thank you.
Much love. Shout out the fam note, man.
We out here.
Yes, sir. Woo. Yeah.